Hello everyone! In this video, I'll give you a breakdown on these lightning particles I made for my game Astro Cat. As always, you can find all the source files you need in the description. So for this effect, we need to look at four parts. A lightning texture, a dissolving shader, a custom particle mesh, and finally it will all come together in the particle system. Let's start with the lightning texture. I'm doing this in Photoshop, but you can do everything I'm doing here in Photopea. It even has all of the same names, and I think even all of the menus are in the same place. Create a new image, 512 by 256. Make the background black. Turn on pattern preview so we can see the tiling of the texture. On a new layer, draw a zigzaggy line. Erase parts of it. Now with layer styles, we will create a distance field effect, which is a gradient around and within the texture that our shader will use. Turn on stroke, set it to gradient. Make sure the blend mode is set to normal. Set the gradient from black to gray. And the style to shape burst. Duplicate the stroke style by clicking the little plus. Reverse the gradient. Set the position to inside. This time setting the gradient from white to gray. And adjust the size so it covers the inside of the lightning zigzag. The texture might look a little bit weird, but it'll make more sense in the next part, which is the shader. Instead of going line by line, I'm just giving a rough overview here, but the shader code linked in the description has comments, and the shader graph will have groups describing what parts of them do, if you want more information. So the shader will sample the lightning texture like normal. Then, to create a cutoff, we step the lightning texture with a slider. This slider is just here for demonstration purposes. In the actual shader, it is driven by custom particle data, but we will get to that later. So the gradient stroke layer style in the texture is now giving us sort of a dissolving effect. Next step, we add in color by sampling a vertical gradient texture on the lightning texture. Then subtract the slider so the lightning will start bright, and while it's fading, go further into the gradient. Now to make it feel a bit more dynamic, just scroll the lightning texture a little on the X of the UV. To make the effect look more 3D, let's make a custom particle mesh. I created a sphere, selected the two center loops and deleted the rest, deleted some of the bottom faces and moved them around a little. Then I repeat this process for a secondary mesh. The UV will be important, so make sure that the UVs are laid out to the whole square. So before we set up the particle system, make sure that you go to the linked post, go all the way to the bottom, and here you will find the shader code. The shader graph is attached. There are two lightning meshes attached, and there's the lightning texture and a gradient texture. When importing the lightning texture, make sure that it is set to import as single channel red. And for the gradient texture, make sure that the wrap mode is set to clamp. I've already set up a material from the shader using these settings. In the scene, I just have a test mesh and a post-processing volume with some bloom on it. Let's create the particle system. First up, in the renderer, add the material we just set up. Then in the base particle settings, set the lifetime to something short, like between 1 and 2. Set the starting speed to 0. Turn on 3D start size and set the X and Z to between 0.5 and 1. And the Y to between 1 and 2. In emission, set the particles over time to between 1 and 3. and at a burst between 5 and 15 every second with infinite cycles. Then in shape, set the type to mesh renderer and select your testing mesh. Turn off the mesh colors just in case, and turn on align with direction so the particle is oriented to the normals of the mesh. Turn on size over lifetime and set the curve to start around 0.7 going up to 1. Then we get to the important one, custom data. Turn it on and set custom 1 to vector. We only need one component and turn this X component into a curve. Set it to go up to almost 1 very quickly at the start. In the renderer, set the particle mode to mesh and select the first of the custom particle meshes. Then click the plus and add the other one. It will choose randomly between the two. You can turn off apply active color space. It might give a better color result depending on your setup. Now turn on custom vertex streams so we can use the curve we made in custom data. Click the plus to add another stream. Choose custom, custom1.x, and you should see the particles fade over time now. At this point the effect is done and you can tweak it however you want. I increase the intensity of the tint in the shader so it glows more. I tweaked the custom data curve for a secondary flash and added another curve to choose between. And that'll do. Looks pretty good, right? So now you can set up your own lightning effect. If you want more info, check the post linked below. And if you want more tutorials like this, check out my GitHub page that has links to all of my tutorials about all sorts of game dev topics. Finally, a huge thank you to my supporters on Patreon who make these tutorials possible. Thanks for watching, have fun, and see you in the next one!